Hi guys, I'm Daddy Freeze, convener of the Free the Sheeple movement and leader of the Free Nation in Christ. I greet you and I bring glad tidings. Today we're talking about allegations that have been leveled against the Free Nation in Christ, calling us a cult. So I'm going to be discussing that here, and we'd be... Somebody said, I thought you were asleep. No, I'm awake. I'm just waiting for this to booth. Now, I'm going to discuss cults on the broad sense from the perspective of religion. And I'm going to use a website, allaboutcults.org. So we're going to read this together. Now, according to allaboutcults.org, the question is asked, what exactly are religious cults? With such a large number of religious organizations and movements in the world today, it is important to understand what we mean when we start labeling certain groups. The dictionary defines cult as a system of religious worship or ritual, devoted attachment to or extravagant admiration for a person, principle, etc. According to this definition, any believer in any god is a member of a cult. In popular media, cult is typically defined as a religious sect whose members are controlled by a manipulative organization or individual. This type of cult is usually portrayed as deceptive, requiring absolute loyalty from its followers. Members are often removed from their prior lives altogether, including their jobs, homes, and families. The Hare Krishnas, Somyong Myung Unification Church, and Moses David Berg's Family of Love are some popular examples of this type of cult. So let's work with the definition. Members are often removed. Let's say it's deceptive, okay? I cannot judge myself as being deceptive or not. I stay 100% true to the true doctrine of Yahushua. But a lot of people who lack understanding might say we're deceptive. Well, I think all your geos are deceptive. We in the Free Nation think virtually 99% of what we have today as Christianity is wrong, it's false, it's based on doctrines of men and traditions of men and very likely on Christ. Let's look at the second word. It says, requiring absolute loyalty from its followers. I'm sure you guys remember when I say, if you don't like my message, unfollow me. That does not require absolute loyalty. It gives you the opportunity to stay with us or leave. Absolute loyalty means you're signing your life away. I still blocked a set of people today. If you're not on our level, I always advise you find somewhere else. It's very plain and easy. We do not require absolute loyalty from our followers. Members are often removed from their prior lives altogether. I want you people to mention one person that has had to give up their jobs, homes, or families because they want to follow the Free Nation in Christ. I don't think you can cite one example. Let's think about it. Let's discuss this. Anyone's given up their job because of the Free Nation? Anyone's given their family up? So, now, this article goes on to define religious cults from the Christian perspective. Christians define religious cults as a different perspective. Simply, a cult is any religious group that deviates from the fundamental teachings of the historic Bible-based Christian faith, as confirmed through the ancient creeds. So the creeds that some clown sat together in 325, that have controlled the world, killed over 100 million people in the last how many centuries, is all of a sudden what we rely on. Instead of digging for true scripture, instead of finding out what really is, we rely on a set of people who manipulated the situation to their own advantage to define us. I don't agree with that. So if they're going to say we're a cult because of this, then they're stupid. They're the ones that are a cult. So their Christian faith is confirmed, not through Christ, but through the ancient creeds. Generally, if a religious organization follows Jesus Christ, but denies or distorts certain essential Christian doctrines, such as the Trinity — the Trinity is not a Christian doctrine. The resurrection, that's a Christian doctrine. Salvation by grace, that's a Christian doctrine. The organization is considered a cult. Okay? Traditional examples are the Mormons, Jehovah's Witnesses, Science, Christian Science, the Unity School of Christianity, and the Way International. All these groups add to the simple gospel of Christ. In addition, some add to the Bible, such as Mormonism, the Book of Mormon, Doctrine and Covenants, and the Pearl of Great Price. Similarly, Christian Science has added science and health with key to the scriptures. The Jehovah Witnesses have actually changed the text of the Bible to make it fit their own version of the doctrine. This I'm not familiar with because I'm not an expert on the occult or religious cults, but we have not modified any scripture to favor us. The only thing we've done is we've gone to the root of scripture to see what they've modified. So that definitely doesn't make us a cult. It makes them a cult. And when Christ says one thing, but your pastor or geo says another, that is modifying the word of God. Who remembers the Gucci pastor who says even if an angel told him that sowing seeds is not real, if God himself told him that sowing seeds is not real, he would laugh because sowing seeds are real. There's a clear example of going against the doctrine of God, actually putting God up to a challenge, and then standing and saying that his doctrine, his ideology, his mentality is superior to whatever could come from God. That is a cult. Now, religious cults add their own rules, rituals, and ceremonies, their own works of righteousness to the finished work of Christ on the cross. These organizations officially state that Christ's sacrifice is sufficient for salvation, but then they go on to say their version of works must be added to the simplicity of his grace in order to warrant true salvation. Clearly, tithing. So when you're tithing, anybody who's collecting tithe from you is not taking you into a church, but into a cult, because you're overthrowing the finished work of Christ on the cross, and now you have your own works. Tithing is works. First fruit, sowing seeds, spraying your pastor's anointing oil, blah, 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 blah. So I'm going to use another definition. This time it's from Pathios.com. And Pathios says, what is a cult? One cult expert defined a cult as a highly manipulative group which exploits and sometimes physically and or psychologically damages members and recruits. We've never even met physically before. The first time we met physically... Okay, we hold physical meetings in Cool FM when we have the sanctuary. And all we do there is help people and teach the gospel. We don't manipulate anybody to their own detriment. But they manipulate people. Imagine a church collects 10% of your salary, February to December. Then in January, they take all of it. They choose days you should fast. They tell you that you can use fasting to kill that ulcer. Now that's a cult. Because fasting will not cure ulcer. It will kill you if you have ulcer. The world defines a cult as any particular group's beliefs and practices that are sufficiently deviant or novel from that of the mainstream and often have ambiguous laws or requirements, so making a precise definition of a cult is rather difficult. Former members describe the cult that they trapped in as a tight-knit group and followed and never deviating from the leader, who is often very charismatic, yet authoritarian. Two former members of a cult said the leader caused the members to lose almost all their privacy, personal property, and civil rights. Am I charismatic? I'd say yes. Do I make you lose your property? I don't even care about your property. The only things I've gotten from the Free Nation are free will gifts. No one's under any form of coercion. Nobody's mandated. Nobody's begged or appealed to give. And I state clearly that gifts to me do not carry a blessing. They're just gifts of love. That alone shows that your property is your property. We don't need your property. I'm not going to take away what rightfully belongs to you. I'm not going to coerce you into giving it to me or into turning it into a church project. You can see that we've been working online. And one of the reasons why we've been working online is we don't want to put pressure on the body of believers into paying things like rent, facility maintenance, security, amenities and all that we would have to pay if we were running a physical church. So nobody's losing anything here except the lies they've been fed. Nobody's going to lose your civil rights. You're not going to lose your civil rights. We actually encourage you to embrace your civil rights in the Free Nation. If I'm lying, please counter this. Some describe Mormonism as a cult. Others see the Jehovah's Witnesses as being one. But any so-called church or Christian organization that claims to have the truth that no one else has but ignores biblical truth. I think we're the only people that actually hold on to biblical truth. Not even biblical truth, scriptural truth. Could well be a cult. One thing that most cults and the world's false religions have in common is that they both require works, which is absolutely contrary to the biblical doctrine of the free gift of grace by God that no work could ever merit. Ephesians 2:8-9. Although I like to follow Ephesians, I'm a Christian, not a Paulian. And there comes to a stage in your walk in Christianity that you remember, that you realize that the apostle to the Gentiles muddled a lot of things up. I can't teach you this on this level, but you're going to come to it. That is why I teach the Free Nation that the Red Bible is the Free Nation Bible. I will not use Ephesians when Yahushua himself said in Matthew 25, reading from 31 to 41, that everyone who ignored him when he was hungry is going to hellfire. And everyone who took care of him when he was hungry, sick, in prison, blah, 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 is going to eternal life. I cannot ignore that because the scripture projects that into the future. It says when the Son of Man comes, not now, when he comes and he will do judgment. He's going to separate the sheep from the goats. So that supersedes any other scripture, including this one in the book of Ephesians. I will never take Paul over Christ. And here Paul and Christ are seemingly at conflict. Eternal life is a free gift. If it involves works, you don't have the gospel that the Bible teaches. I think there are two gospels. There's the gospel of Paul and the gospel of Yahushua. And I have a lot of problems with the gospel of Paul. I have a problem with the law, and I have quite a few problems with the gospel of Paul. That is why we start in Christ. You see, the law, Christ, Christ came out of the law, and out of Christ came the disciples, Paul and all of them. Now, the law had issues. That's why Christ came. What came out of Christ, because of human contradiction and many human mistakes, was also in its own way polluted and put up to much manipulation and exploitation. That is why we are the free nation. Before we take what came out of Christ, we take Christ first. So when you've taken Christ, you've understood Christ, you've understood what he stood for, then you can now start reading Paul, and then you can now start reading the law. Then you have a grasp and understanding of the law, and then you have a grasp and understanding of what Paul is doing. Christ is the midpoint. Christ is zero. Anything before Christ is minus. Anything after Christ is plus. Minus counts down to Christ. 5 AD, 6 AD. Sorry, 5 AD, 4 AD. 5 BC, 4 BC, 3 BC, 2 BC, 1 BC, then zero Christ. Then from Christ it starts, 1 AD, 2 AD, 3 AD. Do you understand? So for you to understand before, you have to understand Christ. When you understand him, he gives you a clear perspective on what was and what is and what would be. I don't know if I've thrown enough light on that. Now, there's so many things I'm going to go ahead and teach you, but not today and not now. Many are not ready. I was in the church for the first time in over 3 years last Sunday, and the only thing I realized was the unreadiness, unscholarliness, the lack of understanding in today's church. The messages that we have in the Free Nation, I teach them, I even withdraw some of them because I'm like, these people are not ready. And you see, the revelation is moving. It's not waiting. You guys need to speed up. You guys need to speed up. You can't, you're at the position where I can almost call regressive, retarding, slow, stagnant. Those are the kind of words I use for where we are as a body in Christ. We're refusing to accept the truth and move with the truth. Instead, we're stagnating on what we want to hear, what we like, what makes sense to us in our lack of understanding. I don't know if I'm making sense. There's so many things I want to teach you. I want to teach you that the Jesus of today's church and Mammon are the same. These are things that I've discussed with my inner circle. You know, things like the Trinity and its roots that are not from Christianity. I want to talk about all those things, but I still feel you're not ready. And the more we teach doctrines that people are not ready to understand and receive, the more they will label us a cult. I don't know if I'm making sense. The more they will label us a cult. Now, there's so many people who want to have discussions with us. quote and unquote. And there's some set of people that I've blatantly refused to have discussions with. And Jigga's aware. They are the people labeling us a cult, that if he's a cult. You see, I do not believe in democracy as a form of government. I do not. Because the problem with democracy is it spawns things that you cannot control. The Chinese government is not democratic, and you will not say they're not successful. The government in Monaco is not democratic, and you will not say it's not a successful nation. My personal belief system. And I tried to make the free nation as democratic as possible, even down to a recent incident where I had to withdraw and say, you know what, somebody's got to ride this horse, somebody's got to drive this car, somebody's got to turn the wheel. And it can be six of us. And like hell, it can be 2,000 of us. It's going to be chaotic. We're going nowhere. If at this stage you are still arguing about Yehoshua, should we call him Yehoshua? Should we not call him Yehoshua? It's not a teaching. It's actually a debate to you. You're a joke, dude. You're a joke. You're a comedy skit. And then today they form alliances, then they break alliances, then I'm not alliancing with anyone. I'm not building the Free Nation doctrine on anybody else. That's why I'm open. If Dr. Sunday Adelaja invites me tomorrow, I'll sit down with him. We'll have a session. I don't draw him close. I don't push him away. I just consider him a brother. He needs me. He puts a call through to me, or his people put a call through to me. I sit down with them. I'm open to discussions with them. I'm open to discussions with everyone, except those who are trying to milk. And I've seen a lot of people milk our platform for their own twisted ideologies and manipulative gains. And here's what I have to say to all of them. I don't need to sit down with you in a discussion. If I see you as not on par with what the Free Nation is teaching, I will not have a discussion. It's insulting to me to even for you to. So it's like a yellow belt wanting to fight with a black belt. It can't be done. Mayweather is lightweight. He cannot fight Michael Tyson, that is heavyweight. They're two different categories. We have people in your class that will willingly hold discussions with you. Don't call me. I'm not your mate. I'm saying this, and I'm saying this clearly to that clown on Facebook. I'm not your mate. Where we are in the Free Nation, you are far behind, lagging behind, trying desperately to build a following and contradicting yourself back and forth. And then he goes on to talk nonsense about my woman. And then he wants to have a discussion with me. He's mad. And then he says, Daddy Freeze, listen. There's one gift I don't have yet. It's the gift of patience. Do you understand? What's his name? Enenche came and cost us the other time. We taught him the scriptures. We taught him the scriptures. He went to fight copyright. If I wanted to do what Enenche did to them, they will not have a single video left. As long as I find one property of mine, one video, one photo of mine on their page, I will drag it down for copyright. Then they will now see what Enenche is, or what Enenche did. They are sitting down trying to compare me to Enenche because I refused to have a debate or discussion with them because I consider them morons, literally. And I hereby warn them, if I see any part of my video in their nonsense that they're doing, I'm going to take them down for copyright. Maybe I should do it to them so they also see what is like. So I've refused to have a discussion with you. Does not mean the Free Nation members don't have a discussion with you. You want to discuss, we'll send you somebody of your level. Do you know why they want me? Because if I come on their platform, I give them clout. Ah, he was able to get Daddy Freeze. Do you know how much they pay me for my time? Have you ever sat down? You saw what I said with my consultancy. You want me to spend 2 hours of my time. What value are you adding to the Free Nation? You are going to drag us. We're going to go back and forth over doctrines that we've established long ago. You're going to take us back to them. We're going to go back and forth. Waste my time that I could use in researching, reading, teaching, preaching, praying, whatever it is that I want to do. And to what avail? What are we going to get out of it? Are you going to help us move our message forward? No, you can't. You don't have. You see, when somebody like Sunday Adelaja calls me, Sunday Adelaja has a platform. We have a platform. He showcases us on his platform. We showcase him on our platform. He helps our message get out. We help his message get out. Symbiotic. I have a platform. Those clowns don't have a platform. When I waste my time with them, what we have is a parasitic relationship. They rob me. I know how many people have come onto the Free Nation platform and have gained recognition from the Free Nation platform and have gone to establish their own thing that is contrary to the Free Nation doctrine. Jigga, where are you? Where are you, Jigga? Many of them come to our platform, not because they believe in us, not because they care, but simply because they need to build a following. And they're like, oh, wow, let's go to Daddy Freeze. That has ended with last year. You're coming on this platform. Is either one, you're paying for it, or two, you're going to help us spread our message, which is the truth about Christ. You're not going to come here. Jigga, I don't want you to mention any names, because if we mention any names, we're giving credit to these clowns. But I'm going to invite you on, and I want us to have a conversation. You know, I want us to have a conversation about this. So let me put a call through to Jigga. You're going to hear his voice. Jigga, where are you? So let's even discuss this, because he was the one that said, look, Daddy Freeze, you have to address this. And I'm going to address it, and I'm going to address it well. It's clear you don't need to follow the Free Nation teachings. Sit down and think. Since you've been following the Free Nation, what did the Free Nation take away from you? If you consider your data wasted, we're sorry about that. Please unfollow us so you don't have to waste more of your data. I'm waiting for Jigga to put a call through to us so we can have him here. So I'm not going to sit down. We have Truth, we have Irene, we have Jigga. Even Jigga, the day Jigga went on their platform, I was mad as hell. I'm like, what are you doing there? You don't realize your power. You're like Free Nation Vice President. What are you going to do on somebody else's platform and go and give them your, you don't know how their following will multiply simply because Jigga Collins gave them audience? No. We have Wolfie. We have people who are ready to take you. If you can now take them successfully, then you can now consider Jigga. But you cannot take Jigga. You want to come to me. You are joking, no? You are joking. And it's obvious you're cloud chasing. Your platform is, he has 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. We have about 36,000. TasteBuds has more subscribers on YouTube than this clown. How can TasteBuds have more subscribers than somebody who wants to come and talk to me? That means you should be discussing with TasteBuds. Truth will always stand is there. You've not invited her to discuss and won her over. You've not invited Wolfie. You've not invited Irene. We have Evelyn. Let them talk to you and see if you'll be able to last 5 minutes with them. I dare you. If you know you want to have a discussion, call any of these people that have called for you and have a discussion with them and see if you last 5 minutes in the ring with them. It's not pride. It's confidence. Chika made a mess of you that day. I watched 5 or 6 minutes of the nonsense before I threw my iPad half across the room, going around trying to clout chase. It's not pride. It's not pride. Go and build a following, mister. Go and get some of those clowns that are following you. Build a following. Then come. You're coming at me 1,500 followers or 1,200 followers and you want me to come and sit down with you. Sit down and talk what? What? Okay. You know what? I'm going to charge you ₦1,000,000 an hour. Pay for my services and I'll have a discussion with you. Raise the money. Let me put that to you. ₦1,000,000 an hour. Raise the money and I'll have a discussion with you. I think that's the deal. Abi, guys, what do you think? Because he's saying I'm proud now. If you can afford to pay for my time, ₦1,000,000 an hour, raise it. You have your boy, you have people there. Just tell them to donate. Then you have donated. I'll give you my account details. Pay the money into my account. Then let's have a debate. Olushi. He's saying people had discussion with Christ. Not everybody could get near Christ too. So Baba, fight no day. Fight no day. And you know why I'm billing him? Because he talked crap. Crap that he has no knowledge of. Little understanding of. About my relationship with Taste Buds. Stuff that you don't know. Then you go and you say, and then he said, I'm not judging them. You are mad. You think Creflo Dollar them came to Nigeria free of charge? Like, dude. Come on. You pay for Creflo Dollar to come to Nigeria and then you want my time free. After you have insulted me. After you, when you're not going to add any value to us. He swore at my son's mother. So I'm going to swear at his mother too. Like I've said, I'm still praying every day for the gift of patience and cool temper. The Holy Spirit has not yet given me. And there's a reason why. Because of people like this clown. You go and insult me. You insult Sunday Adelaja. And then you now come bloody hypocrite. Bloody hypocrite. I'm going to call you what you are. Go and call what is. Go and talk a lot of nonsense up and down. And then the next thing you want to have a discussion. Go have a discussion with your mother. Somebody said you are out of here. Let me block you so you don't need to come back again, ever. Like I said, this is not a cult. You can never see our videos again. You want a debate? There are people in the Free Nation who have a debate with you. Stop clout chasing. You want me to mention your name? That's your name. That if I use my mouth to mention your name, I'm giving you credibility. You know who you are. You are watching the video. Is there saying pride goes? I'm not proud. Anybody who has met me before knows that I'm not proud. But because I don't take nonsense, he wants to label me as proud. Okay, me, I'm proud. You are stupid. You are ignorant. And I say that because I know. Dude was quoting Revelation. Person that has no wonder. I think quoting Revelation that Jesus has a new name. Oh, that Christ has in you. I'm like, these are the people you want me to sit down with? Oh. Now, I mean, I go tell you my mind. You should be happy that Jiga came on your dead platform. Jigito.
Bro, calm down. I understand, but just calm down. Just
come on, man.
Keep the anger, because I mean, there's no need, man. There's no need.
The guy should stay in his lane. He should stay in his freaking lane. He wants a discussion. He should write to the Free Nation formally. We'll give him somebody to discuss with him.
Yeah, I mean, let's just forget the issue, bro. I mean, you're angry, and because you're angry now, you're gonna say some things that, you know, you might not even like eventually. You know.
So you know me. There's nothing I've said that I don't like.
I know. You see, you might eventually regret it, because some things that you don't need to say some things. So just calm down, bros. Calm down, big. I know you're angry. I know you don't like the fact that he crossed the line. I understand. We spoke about that.
Like, dude, come on. But why would you talk about my woman? And then you say you are not judging. Then the next thing you say, I refuse to have a discussion. I refuse to talk. I refuse to acknowledge that you exist as a human being.
Bro, then what,
Jigga, I want you to ask me, what does he want to come and discuss? Let me discuss. What does he want to come and discuss? What does he want to come and say?
He wants to challenge certain statements you made.
What are the statements? What are the statements?
From my conversations with him, the major thing is the fact that you said Christ is not the only way, and the other part you said the God of the Muslims and Yahweh is the same, and what else? I mean, those are the two things I think.
He thinks the God of the Muslims and the God of the Christians are different, Abby. He's a goat.
Yes.
He's a goat.
Well, I mean, me myself.
No, Jigga, but I'm not insulting him. He's a goat. That will not be insult. He's a goat. If he lacks that level of understanding. Okay, well, maybe those people that are worshiping their pagan gods and the God of the Muslims are different. But let me break it down like this. The God of the Free Nation and the God of the Muslims is the same. What else is his problem?
Those are the two major things. And maybe the fact that, yes, and he's like, your tongue, you're very brash. And
Baba, I never collect the gift of patience. I still search for him.
Well, bro, just calm down.
Really, I still search for him. Baba, you see, I'm not angry with him. I'm angry at the nonsense. How dare you call us a cult? Do you know the definition of a cult? Do you know that he gathered some foolish people the other day? I don't know who even sent me that nonsense. Please, can you guys never ever send me videos from this guy again? Anybody that sends, I'll flip on you, not understand what is going on. Please. As far as I'm concerned, he doesn't exist. He believes in his own foolishness and his own gospel. He should propagate it wherever he is. Do it the way he understands. Gain his followership. God is with him. I don't acknowledge that he exists. Simple. As far as I'm concerned, when Paul stood in front of the Galatians in Galatians chapter 3 and called them all foolish and bewitched, he was angry because they neglected the truth and they were holding on to their ideologies. So me standing here and calling him a fool is not out of place. It's not out of place. He's teaching nonsense. So it's not out of place, bro.
Yeah, but bro, any which way, calm down, please. I beg you, please. I always beg you that you should calm down. Just calm down. I tell people, the DF I knew 2 years ago and the DF I know now is a different person. Even on your post, you don't blast people as much as you used to. And that's why I believe that you're getting there. You're at least, God is using you. He's taking away that thing you don't have. Like I told someone recently, we can't all be perfect. Even Paul had a thorn in his flesh. I'm not going to condemn you because you're brash in your delivery sometimes. I know it's something that comes with anger. When you're angry, you go that way. Because some people will hold on to the fact that, I mean, somebody sent me a message the other day saying, how can you listen? Be listening to that phrase, it doesn't have the spirit of God, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, no, you can't say that. Even Paul, Peter, sliced somebody's
ear. Did Peter not cut somebody's ear? Where was the spirit of God when Peter was cut? Have I cut anybody's ear? Have I cut his ear?
You can't say because sometimes you we are human. Don't forget the fact that our humanity leads us sometimes. So, by the end of the day, we have to strive towards perfection, even though we won't get there.
Yeah, we're striving towards perfection, but but you see, I try as much as possible to stay within the lane of the free nation. Yes, we discuss doctrinal flaws from the Pentecostal churches and all that, yes. But you see, the greatest problem with the reformers is the reformers. They're fighting within themselves. Today, they are with this pastor, then tomorrow they are fighting him. I can't work with people like that. You are concentrating.
I don't consider ourselves as reformers.
We are not reformers. The Free Nation is not. We're not with them. We're not with them in ideology. We're not with them in spirit. When we're just not with them. Pure and simple.
I agree. Because when you go online now and you see what the so-called reformers are doing, you'd be ashamed to even be found. Talking to them, because it's all about bringing somebody down and all in the name of I stand with the truth and all that. It's just a shame. I don't understand it. I can't even deal with it. So much drama, so much today one person is your friend, tomorrow the person is your enemy. The same person you can't tell people bad about. Now, you know, I'm like, no, you don't do things like that. I'm not saying you should remain your enemy forever, but if this person can be your friend today,
you know, the problem is, let me tell you, I have no problem. Jigga, me and you still fought over some people that you sent to me and I opened my platform for.
True.
Are we both not regretting it today?
Just a mess.
Are we not both regretting it today?
Yeah.
So I have learned, if there's nothing you are bringing, and all these people were nobodies who just needed a push. And yes, we gave them a push, and where are they today? What are they doing with the push? So here's the thing. I'm not bringing anybody onto our platform unless that person can, one, afford it. I'm going to actually monetize it. 1M per hour, you cannot pay, it's not per second. If you're going to have a 10-minute meeting, you pay for the first hour. If you're going to have a 1 hour, 5 minutes, you pay for 2 hours. So prepare yourself, and I'll clear my table for you, and I'll sit down with you and go through whatever it is you want to go through. And trust me, it will not be money wasted. But anything apart from that, don't even think about it. It shouldn't even cross your mind.
I just believe that some people cannot wrap their head around the fact that God is not a religious God.
Jigga. Do you know the level we are in the Free Nation? I'm not even talking of the Free Nation as a whole. Me, you, and Irene, when we speak of the doctrines, that's why I comfortably said we are black belters. We cannot be challenged by yellow belt. For martial art, yellow belt and black belt, they are not the same kedar, they're the same category. So you cannot come and be dragging us back to 8 doctrines or 12 doctrines ago, and that is where you are, that's where your problem is. I've told you, when Christ spoke of God, he used the words Elaha, Allaha, and that is the same God of the Muslims. I don't see why it's a debate. Why is it a debate? Did the Muslims not come from Ishmael, the son of Abraham, whom God blessed? Abi?
To realize, we Christians, some of us have come to understand that the Bible was infiltrated, and some sound Muslims know that their own Quran itself was infiltrated. So we Christians, because most of us are bigots, we point out the bad things in their Quran, and the bigoted Muslims point out the bad things in our own Bible, and that's what the devil wants. That's what the devil wants. Just want us to be confused. But there's only one supreme God. Me, there's nothing that will change that will make me think otherwise. Because the God that I serve, the God I have come to understand, you can't put him in a box of religion. He cannot. So even Allah, Yahweh, you can't. It won't fit. Muhammad, the prophet of the Muslims, his primary message Christ came to teach. So where, I mean, it's just people just can't understand it, you know, because we've been schooled in error for ages, and we to unlearn some things, it's going to take longer. It's going to take strength. It's going to take grace. It's going to take grace. So all these people that are going around to say the Free Nation is a cult, and that when I see things, I get really upset because I know I'm not part of any cult, you know. Just because we don't buy into your ideology of putting God in a box does not mean we're a cult. You get what I'm saying? Just because we don't support your ideology of, the God of everybody must become a Christian to make heaven, doesn't mean we're a cult.
There are clear Bible verses that contradict that.
Yeah.
Luke 10:25, clear
so
biblical.
Many. You know, he didn't come to for just a. Christ is universal. He's universal.
You know what pisses me off when a three-dimensional being is trying to box a multi-dimensional being. Can you even create a box that will hold that being?
Like, what are you thinking? Like, you know, and now the scriptures, which is our own reference, which is our reference point, we know it is infiltrated. We know you, if you don't, any Free Nation member, any Christian alive that think the Bible is what it is, and there's no minus or there's no plus in it, that person is the moron.
You should have done the vex now. You should have done the vex now.
I the vex, but bro, no, I the vex on the level of my general vex. I the vex for everybody when they think that way. Do you understand? I'm not the vex for one particular person because he's not the only one. It's just that I feel like you and this guy, and I get some kind of vendetta. You know, I don't understand.
Baba, no get vendetta with her. He's too small.
Yeah,
no, they talk and like vendetta. Know. If you talk and say na vendetta, be like say me and Nam did the same range. It's too small to get vendetta. Are they talking for public? I know they. You see, Baba, one thing with me is nothing where they talk, where they fear.
No. See, that is one of the reasons.
I'm not going to insult him again. If I insult him before, making no vex, because I know they like to insult people. And for a long time, I've not insulted people. But me and him, we know they the same level. That one no be insult. That one a fact. Day and night, no be the same.
Bro, just pray him. Please, just ignore him. You know one of the reasons why I like you and I love you as a brother? Besides, say we've come over the past 1.5 years or 2 years, we've developed a strong bond, revelation and everything, the spirit and all, is you're not a hypocrite. And it's hard to find, a person that is not a hypocrite. It's very, very hard. You can find people who are nice, gentle, calm, loving and all, but it's hard to find a man that is not hypocritical. You know what I'm saying? And that alone is why I can stand and defend you any day, anytime, because I know that you do it as you've said it, and you won't do something, and you won't say one thing and go and change it behind. And I told the same person the other day, I said, listen here, I'm like, I would rather follow a wolf that comes to me as a wolf than a wolf that comes to me as a sheep. Because if a wolf comes
Word.
To me as a wolf, you know what I mean? If a wolf comes to me as a wolf, I know that when I'm following you, I will hold my shield and my cutlass. You know what I'm saying? Because I know you're a wolf. One day, if you're hungry, won't chop me. You understand? But if a wolf comes to me as a sheep,
you let your guard down.
I will lose guard. You understand? I will lose guard. So, it's better. That's why sometimes, when I see you get, you're angry and all that, I'm like, this is that. And I've been telling myself, let's freeze. You have to understand that He's coming from the industry. He's a radio personality, you know. But still, I know that if you say you're a leader and you're in the spirit, some things you have to, some character, some traits you don't have to exhibit. I know that.
You know, Jigga, in all fairness to me, in all fairness to me, even with the leaders of the church that we consider the biggest problem in Christianity today, I have toned down I have started talking to them like I'm talking to human beings. There was a point in my life where I was really angry at what they've done. But you see, at the end of the day, I realized that it's not them. They just got caught in establishment. So even with them, I've toned down. The only person who has made me angry this year is this same person. Is this same person. You don't go and insult somebody, then the next thing you want a discussion, and then you announce it publicly that he doesn't grant you a discussion that you are what? That a bat flew out of a cave and now needs a discussion? A worm crawled out of the ground and needs a discussion. Like, what does he think me to be? You see, there are things you say with pride and there are things you say with confidence. I know where the message of the free nation is. You and I know the type of people I have conversations with.
Word.
Do you understand? He doesn't know.
Truth.
He doesn't know the level at which the elders have come, and we are talking. These are elders. And then he comes from his point of view and stamps his foot on the ground and says he wants a discussion. Obviously, he's clout chasing. I'm not saying this from a point of pride, but he is clout chasing.
Yeah, because another thing I don't understand, and I feel like it doesn't make sense to me, is you're forming a cult, yeah, you only have less than 100,000 genuine followers. You're almost 110,000 genuine followers, right?
Probably even 5 or 6.
5,000, yeah, let's say 5,000 genuine followers. There are people out there with millions of followers that it is a known fact that they are cults, yeah? That they are, this one will be biblical facts. It's clear that these people are milking people, but you are not chasing those people. You're chasing a man with 5,000 followers who has a common ground with you, you understand? And you're trying to bring him down, but you've not brought the establishment down. You know what I'm saying?
Jigga, you know, there's a conversation you and I had the other day. I'm like, the moment we see somebody whom is talking to us, we're having mediation sessions. We should not fight that person publicly. Because for somebody to come up to us and have conversations with us, it means we have what you call common ground. Paul found common ground with everyone. It's part of the reason why the church is in the jeopardy it is today, but we cannot ignore it because Paul did it. So when we find common ground, we're like, look, we can't fight everyone. If somebody lends us half a finger of support, it's better for us not to fight him so we can concentrate on the real matter out there. Because at the end of the day, you are calling yourselves reformers. I today declare that I'm not part of any reformation. I'm not part of any group of reformers. We are the free nation in Christ, a nation free of the shackles of religion, lies, and manipulation. That's what we are. All right, welcome back. So Jigga's here. So like I was saying, we are not a part of any reformation, any reformers. We are the free nation in Christ. Yeah, our duty and our responsibility is to bring the truth about Christ, about Yahushua, not the Jesus that evolved out of the doctrines and ideologies of men and establishments of men, but Yahushua. We're
okay,
going
bro. Okay,
back.
yeah, just keep
Why?
expanding.
Because, Jigga, you're a pilot. You'd understand. When you go off track, the first thing you do is you go back, you try to get back to the original heading.
Yes.
We've missed. We've gone off track. So we're trying to get back on track. Now, I have a problem with the reformers. They are a bunch of clowns, literally, fighting amongst themselves, bickering, going nowhere. Going nowhere. I can see them. Where they are today is where they will be in the next 5 years. You see that I said it. Where they are today is where they will be. They'll just dance around it. You know when you dance around. You see, let me ask you something. The Free Nation in January 2018 and the Free Nation in June 2018, are they the same?
No.
The Free Nation in June 2018 and December 2018, are they the same?
Grown.
The Free Nation in December 2018 and April 2019, are they the same? We are dynamic. We are in revelation. We are chasing the truth. We are chasing the truth in revelation.
Correcting our errors.
Correcting our errors. Coming onto new understanding of the truth because we're walking in the Spirit. We're growing. And let me tell you something. The world is recognizing our growth. The world is seeing us.
Yeah.
The world, there's going to be a time when there's a lot of persecution on us. So I hate it when, okay, you say you are reformers. We're all supposed to be working together to erase the falsehood in the doctrine. Then you are now fighting me. It's like, what are you people trying to be? The superior reformers? That's why we have today announced. But that is what, that's what's coming from. If we're all reformers, shouldn't we have a common enemy? A divided house
cannot stand.
So I will not stand with you. Stay there and be divided. We know who our enemy is, and the enemy is 1, Mammon, 2, Nimrod, 3, the establishment. That, those are our primary, those are the principalities and powers that control the world today. 2 Corinthians 4:4. Satan, who is the God of this earth. Papa, we are supposed to be fighting Satan. You are fighting me and trying to show from a place of inferiority. I've not heard one scripture from this set of clowns that makes authoritative sense. Not one. I have talked to Pentecostal pastors that have made scriptural sense. Jigger, remember what I told you about the dove that we discussed? They did not follow you for a whole day. Whether you agree that is right or is wrong, it dwelled in your mind. It consumed your mind for a portion. Remember that, that doctrine?
Yes, yes. I remember. I came back to you now.
Do you understand? And that's the Pentecostal pastor. Then you're now sitting to, you are listening to reformers watered down. It's like they took, they boiled Indomie. They now poured like 3 buckets of water inside the Indomie. Then that packet of flavor, instead of them to even put the one packet of flavor, they now put half of it. So the Indomie is swimming in the water, no taste, no flavor, nothing, just watered down establishment doctrines. You know they work with establishment doctrines. Because if you stand up and say the God of the Muslims is different from the God of the Christians, you are working with the establishment. That's what the establishment wants.
Exactly. That's what they teach.
So, what makes you different from them? What makes you a reformer? Reformer by name, Mugun by behavior. Baba, I don't know how I go take talk these people matter. We, I know they vex again, but there no way person no go to jab them because they're foolish. As in, these people carry this foolishness for head like gala. They hawk on for main road, buy foolishness. 2 for 10 naira, buy foolishness.
understand what you mean. But just calm down.
I know they vex again, no. I don't even apologize to them. Say me they no vex. But that discussion, if they want them, I don't even say I go do them, but they go pay for them. Because me no be their mate. I talk that one clear. May they go gather themselves. I no be una mate. No be by pride. If you want a discussion, no problem. We'll scramble a team for them. We'll send them a team.
They should spend more time trying to bring down the establishment.
Thank you. They should spend more time facing the establishment. Guess what? Go and watch the highest selling videos on their platform are the videos that they talk about Daddy Freeze. Are they lie jigger?
Yeah, true.
Not true. As in, when they mention Daddy Freeze, they have 20,000 views. When they do their normal joking around and faffing around and retardation and watered down Indomie, they have 200 views.
You know why that is? Because
I said, come on.
Because the established.
So as they don't see, say, oh boy, will they buy them clout? Oh, they don't come. Papa, we know your strategy. And we will not nurse it. We will not feed it. We will not encourage it. It's all right. You could do whatever you want to do. Yes. But you see, okay, yes.
Hang on a second. Sorry, it was because of him. I'm alive. Sorry.
You know? Sorry. Uh-huh. So like I was saying, where was I?
About the views.
Yes. So okay, I will give you those views you want. I will give you. You know, because I will now come there live and I will open my mouth and they will see my picture and they will see me and you talking the way me and Jigga are talking. So I will give you those views. No problem. In fact, you will go from 20,000 to 50,000. I guarantee you. In fact, I will even promote it on my own page so that they will know. 1 million naira per hour. Finish. Let's consider it a consultancy.
Even people when did the establishment itself would join one watch which they go on. Do you understand? Say,
yes, no.
Somebody won't take this thing down. But I just feel like, what's the point of doing that? You know, most of them say, oh, it's for Christ. We are doing it for Christ. But there is a bigger problem out there that is consuming people, and you're facing somebody just because you don't agree with him on two or three things, you know? Yeah, you've agreed with him before, because most of these people, they've agreed with you before, but wait till they piss me off, I say, most of them are because, say, you talk, say, Christ is not the only way.
You see, that's now, they need to explain, they need to let me explain that, because they jumped and they ran with it. Christ is the way. Now, Sunday Adelaja seems to understand this a little bit better than they do. That is why, in as much as a lot of people have issues with Sunday still makes more sense than all these guys. You see, what I was trying to say is, there are, I can't say it here because, do you understand? Because it will involve things that what the church teaches today, they do not understand. But I'll explain it with two scriptures. Luke 11:25, when the detestable Samaritan made heaven, and Matthew 25, 31 to 41. Just read these two scriptures. They explain how eternity can be achieved. Now, you see, it's not like you are not going through Christ, but you are not going through being born again and receiving this Bible, and you are going through the Christ in the poor. You are going through the Christ in love, the Samaritan in...
Let me add to that scripture.
Yes.
Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that calls me Lord, Lord, Lord will make heaven, but those that do the will of my Father. What does that mean? Now, if you remember Christ, every time he's...
Hold on. I want to read you another scripture. Okay, no, it's okay, it's good. No problem. Revelation 22:15. Okay. The kids need to go to bed, so the light is disturbing. Revelation 22:15, I'll round this off. I'll read from 14, and let's read this together. Blessed are those who wash their robes. They will be permitted to enter through the gates of the city and eat the fruit from the tree of life. Outside the city are the dogs, the sorcerers, the sexually immoral, the murderers, the idol worshippers, and all who love to live a lie. It does not say outside the city are the non-born again. It does not say outside the city are the non-Christians. Let's read who is outside the city of God together. Let's read it together. The dogs. It does not say the Christian dogs or the Muslim dogs or the pagan dogs. The dogs. Are we? The sexually immoral. It does not say the Christian sexually immoral or the pagans, the sexual immoral. The murderers. Whether you're a Christian or a Muslim, as long as you're a murderer, you're outside the city. The idol worshippers.
Like Jesus.
And all who love to live a lie. If you are still calling Jesus, you are living a lie. You are outside the gate. So it is, you see, there's so many scriptures like this. If you read Matthew 25, 41, let me just, I'll round off with this. Matthew 25, 41. Let me read this to you. Then he will say to those on the left, depart from me, you cursed ones, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his demons. Why are they in the hellfire? One, I was hungry. You didn't feed me. Two, I was thirsty. And you didn't give me a drink. Three, I was a stranger. And you didn't invite me into your home. Four, I was naked. And you didn't give me clothing. Five, I was sick. Six, I was in prison. And you didn't visit me. It does not include Muslims. It does not include pagans. It's simply those who refuse to see the Christ represented by the poor. And what did it take? According to this scripture, what did it take to make heaven? Love. So if you do not see the love in Christ and you think you can tie him down in some religious masturbation where you guys tickle yourselves and tickle your fancies and faff around with your external genitalia to please yourselves into believing you have a true doctrine. Because that's what they do.
This is what the devil wants, bro. That's what the devil, that's how he has infiltrated the world.
And what does God describe it as in the book of Ezekiel chapter 16 and Ezekiel chapter 23? Harlotry.
Adultery.
Yeah. That is it. That you guys are committing adultery. And this is what they want me to sit down with them and be discussing so that I can, Baba, 1 million naira. Write a letter to us. We'll send you our account details. The government cannot mandate us to have a discussion with you. Neither can the church or anybody else. You want a discussion, you're going to pay for it. Jigga Collins, round off so I can close this.
I don't know what to say. Just let them, free them. I think it's Titan, you totally ignore them, there's no point to debate. We already know where they stand and they know where we stand.
If I say I'm not going to debate them, it will now look like I'm afraid of them. No, you're just going to pay for my time. And let me tell you what that debate comes. I will even announce it on the radio, Seth. I will dash you radio airtime, Seth, that I'm going to have a debate with so-so and so-and-so person. Baba, the blogs go gather, everybody go gather. That following way they find, you will grow them. But it's not going to be free.
Anyways, guys, the free nation is here to stay. Somebody said the free nation is here to stay. We are here to stay, you know. And every day the revelation is pouring in. And
Jigga, between you and I, is today's session not a waste of time?
Absolutely.
In all honesty. In all honesty. Absolutely. Is this what me and you discussed as revelation last night?
No.
Is this where we are supposed to be?
No.
So it's a waste of our time even listening. I don't want to sound angry because I was angry initially, but I'm not angry again. Here's the thing. And I'm not saying this again. You want a discussion, pay for it. I will oblige you. And after that's done, we close your chapter and we move on to the more pressing things. I will stop and throw stones at barking dogs, but not let it be one of us pretending to be a dog or one of us not realizing that he's human and thinking he's a dog and now barking at us. It becomes confusing.
Bro, no need. Just let them be. I mean, you've made your point. We are not going to change our stand our understanding is not going to change tomorrow or the day after. So,
you know, remember there's something he said, Jigga, about marriage, that I said that the only way you can get married is... if there's alcohol present or something like that. He tried to jump on. I put it to him. How does he should describe a Christian wedding with scriptures. How a Christian is supposed to hold a wedding. I put it to him. He should give us the scriptures. Chebi won't discuss. Mo give an assignment. Chebi in talk, say, I don't know what he's going to talk. Make he give us scriptures. You think that nonsense you would do inside your temples up and down? You think that's Christian wedding? You people are fooling yourselves. Well, Jigga, we have plenty of things to deal with. Bless you, my brother. Bless you, everyone, for listening.
Take care of yourself.
Sorry if I went off. Irene, I can see you. God bless you, my dear sister. Wolfie, Chini, fine babe. We had quite a lot of people come out today.
Evelyn was here. I saw Evelyn as well.
Okay, I didn't quite see her. No, don't. Somebody said we're giving him audience. No, we're not giving him. You know the painful thing is, we know they mention his name. So now only him, no, say now him we they talk to. And one or two people. him. I know they follow around talk. God bless you guys. God bless you all.
Evelyn.
Okay, yeah, that's Evelyn. I've seen her. So take good care of yourself. Jigga, me and you go talk tomorrow plenty. Posh Mama Yinkus.
Hey, Posh Mama.
Come.
Don't go chop wish me.
Posh mama, they provoke. Posh mama, Rake, give my papa. Rake, give taste buds. Say, daddy, you were in the car and they were driving like this. But not be Posh mama fault. We carry Posh mama waka inside bush. 1 hour. Moving. See, Shukwa 2, Shukwa Vaughn, I see you.
Yeah.
The give me voice. Chine fine babe. Dagnet is here. Wow. Dagnet, how are you doing? Dagnet, please don't mind me. I'm not like this. I've not been like this in a long time. It's just that some people just tick me off and they make me sound like... I tell my sitter, first mama say I almost died of fear. We came back. My papa not even fit chop the bush meat again.
That bushmeat looked well grilled.
Baba, you have no idea until you taste it with some communion wine. Instead of them, may they tell us, may they follow us, go where the thing they happen. May we give them some communion wine. They fight us. Instead of they see the real fight for ground. Antelope, they fight antelope. Lion, they come. They don't see the lion. Now, where did they go on? Antelope, they fight antelope. Lion, they come. So me, I've decided that me, I'm not antelope with them again. No, me, I'm giraffe. Antelope and giraffe, no, they cross. So them be antelope, we be giraffe. We they go our own. And we get long neck. We go see the lion, they come from far.
We they see them.
We they see them from far. God bless you guys. God bless you.